What if you don't have the bottom adjustment, only the spring adjustment? Yeah, so what Peter's talking about there is he's saying in this particular coilover, which is it's relatively common for what we see today, certainly in older style coilovers, you don't always see this. He's talking about the fact that you don't have a lower mount always. In that case, it's really important that the coilover that you buy is suited to your exact application, because this relationship between the where the wheel and where the damper is so important. It becomes really important that the damper is specifically set for your application, because if you've got no way of adjusting this, it means that you're stuck with the full compression and rebound stroke that you've got. Now, I wouldn't say you're completely stuck. I would say that you're more stuck than if you've got this adjustment. I mean, if you've got a situation in that case where you've with your spring and damper, so let's do that example again. So in the first part of that example where I said you fully compress your suspension, and let's say you have got contact between the wheel and the inner guard and the tire. So essentially, if you haven't got this adjustable mount and you need to reduce you need to increase the gap between the tire and the chassis, the only way you've really got to do that is by adding spaces on the damper itself. So let's say what you would typically have is machine a spacer, the size, say out of aluminium or something like that, the size that you need to reduce the height of the wheel, sorry, to move the wheel further away from the chassis. And the idea is there that the bump stop would sit on top of that. And the problem with that, obviously that's reducing the fact that it's meaning you have got no contact now between the wheel and the chassis. The problem with that is that you've now reduced your effective suspension travel. So that's a big problem. It means now you've got much less travel available to you. Well, I should say it can be a big problem. It depends on your application. If you're running on really smooth circuits and stuff, it's much less of a problem. If you're running on street circuits or really bumpy tracks, that's when it can become a much bigger problem. Because now you've got much less suspension travel, and as a result, you're going to need to run a higher stiffness of suspension or much larger or much more effective bump stops, or you're going to spend much more time on the bump stops, which can be a big problem as far as reducing the available grip you've got. So there are ways you can get around that, but unfortunately, it becomes a pretty big problem as far as regaining all of your bump travel. You can go to more extreme lengths to recover that as far as moving where your top mount mounts in your car. So if you've got a top plate that mounts to the car, if you were to cut the top plate off and actually move that up in your car, that would be one way of recovering some of that suspension travel. But that tends to be, it's a pretty invasive thing when it happens at the front of the car. There's often not a huge amount of room to actually move the top mount up, even if you want to start cutting the top of your strut tower off and moving that point up. Often it runs into the bonnet really quickly. But incidentally, if you do see cars, particularly older race cars with McPherson struts, you can often see a lump where the dampers are mounting to the top and the bonnet. That's usually for that exact reason. It's because they run out of compression travel in order to recover their stroke. They've moved that top mount up, and that's the reason you see that. If you like free stuff, and you'd like to learn more about optimizing the performance and handling of your car on the racetrack, as well as improving your skills behind the wheel, then we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description of this video to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You're guaranteed to learn a lot, and you'll have a chance to ask questions which we'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so click the link to claim your spot.